Now, written and directed by Sir David Hare, the new BBC drama Page 8 features a cast of British acting heavyweights, including Bill Nighy, Michael Gambon, Rachel Weisz and Ralph Fiennes.
It tells the story of an MI5 operative, played by Bill, as he tries to investigate a threat to the security service stability when his boss dies, and it's already receiving high praise. We'll talk to Bill in just a moment, but first, a little look at what lies in store.
Morning, Mona.
Good morning.
So there's an awful lot of stuff going on. An awful lot of traffic.
What does that mean? Intercepts?
Among other things. This building is swimming in information. We have information coming out of our ears.
So
the difficult thing is to notice when someone finally tells you something important. Our reaction. He thinks he can be rude to me. He thinks he can treat me how he wants because we had a wife in common.
In my case, a long time ago.
All your wives are a long time ago.
Is Jill need to know on my wives?
Everyone knows about your wives.
So my point is this. I've called the two of you together. I want to share a source. And before we go any further, God's very excited.
Why is God excited?
I suppose, like all Home Secretaries, God can't resist a file marked top secret.
You're going to read this. And you're going to think, hold on, the Americans are meant to be our allies.
I've never suffered from that delusion.
Johnny doesn't believe in a special relationship, do you?
They're not what you call sharing partners, are they?
Even you can't claim to have read it already.
I've seen certain words. I gather we're back in the Middle East.
We're always in the Middle East.
I don't like faith jobs. I don't know anything to do with faith.
You haven't seen any of it?
Apart from when I have to do dubbing. You have to do dubbing.
Right.
And then you have to look.
Bill?
We're just discussing the background of this programme, which is fascinating.
We were just saying, because normally we get a preview, but none of us have had a preview, and you were saying you haven't seen it.
No, I haven't seen it. I'm a bit squeamish when it comes to watching myself, so no, I haven't.
So you won't get to see it at all now? You won't?
This is a contentious point. It's possible that I won't. Maybe when I'm very old.
Now, let's get it clear. People think of Spooks and, I don't know, James Bond, perhaps. Just describe to us what your character is like, Bill. He looks a little bit, if I might say, the sort of mature operative.
Well, I do mature, yeah. He's certainly that. I play an MI5 operative. My boss is Michael Gambon. And I am I come into the possession of a dossier which incriminates people in very, very high places. So it's a thriller. It's an entertaining thriller, but it concerns itself with current issues. And as you've already said, because it's David Hare, he was able to attract this incredible cast, and we have Rachel Weisz, who came to play the girl who lives across the hall.
Yes, and as you say, because it was David, so many people were attracted to it, but also there's... I mean, would you say it's thinly veiled, the political references in terms of contemporary issues?
I'm not at liberty to discuss that, but you should ask David about that. But it's strange when things are written and then public life starts to very specifically chime with something that's been invented. But obviously, as you'll see, if you see the programme, I think you will recognise... events and things that have been happening recently.
Mm. David Hare always writes from a perspective, shall we say, and I think the Ralph Fiennes character, I think he plays the Prime Minister, doesn't he?
He does, yeah.
And people are going to see some parallels with a relatively recent incumbent of Downing Street, Tony Blair.
Well, perhaps the current one. It's possible, yeah. I mean, I'm sure that people will come to their own conclusions.
Yeah.
He said...
Well, let's take another look, and we'll see your character reacting rather angrily to having a faulty pass.
Ah.
Age old problem.
Quite.
What is this? They're saying I need a new pass. I was given a temporary. What's going on?
Are you
going
to throw a wobbly?
Of course I'm not going to throw a wobbly. When was the last time I threw a wobbly?
7/7?
Exactly. I threw a wobbly because suicide bombers killed 56 people on the streets of London and we had no idea it was going to happen. I didn't throw a wobbly because my pass had been blocked.
Mm. Quite grim stuff there.
I see.
Now, it had very good reviews because it premiered at the Edinburgh Film Festival, a lean political thriller, said the Evening Standard. In terms of the research that David Hare did, he said that he did talk to people in MI5. He said they were perhaps more open with him than they might have been with journalists. Do you get involved in that process? Are you privy to some of those conversations, or do you just go with the script as it is?
Well, I'm old enough now to admit that when people ask you the question, how much research did you do for this part, I'm now old enough to say absolutely none whatsoever. I just any information I need is in the script, really. Yes, it did premiere at the Edinburgh Film Festival, and it's also been chosen to close the Toronto Film Festival as the closing film, and also to open the Warsaw Film Festival, so it's already been received rather well.
And Rachel Weisz, she's a little bit younger than you, Bill, isn't she?
Is that a problem?
No, not at all. I was just going to ask you...
I'm glad you asked that.
Well, is this the main love interest? I mean, don't associate David Hare with sort of romance, to be honest. But that
really? I've worked with him many times, more times than anyone else. I don't think I've been in any of his plays that didn't involve romance. I don't think you could get, with all due respect, I don't think you could get anyone more more committed to a romantic idea than David.
Oh.
But she is, she's more than just the love interest. She's there to involve us in another great issue which is currently on our screens.
Do you think there's a possibility that this character of yours could live on and you could find yourself playing this agent in lots more versions of the same thing?
Well, I'm lobbying very hard. I'd be very happy. I wear a dark blue overcoat, I smoke herbal cigarettes in the rain, I stand on Battersea Bridge in the dark, and you have to worry about what I'm thinking. It's a kind of perfect role. But there are moves. They are keen to have more. So there may be.
And what else are you up to at the moment? Busy as ever.
Well, I've been very busy. Yeah, I'm in a movie called Jack the Giant Killer. I am the giant. I'm 22 feet tall and I eat people. And I'm also a one-eyed demigod with a very long beard and a limp in Clash of the Titans 2. If you can check me out.
How exciting! See, wonderfully eclectic.
Yeah. Fantastic, Bob. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Well, Bill Nighy, thanks very much.
Lovely to see you, as ever.
Great to see
and you.
And
you can see Page 8 on BBC 2 on Sunday night at 9 o'clock. Look forward to seeing it. Thank you.
Pleasure.